To give you a bit of background, the Polo Vivo is Volkswagen's ultimate budget car in South Africa right now. That title was previously held by the VW app, but it has since been discontinued in SA. Few years ago, this car was sold as a Polo TSI, but in 2018, VW launched the new Polo TSI and then detuned the previous TSI and called it a Polo Vivo. The car is completely the same as the old TSI. Here they literally just removed the 3D Polo TSI lettering and put a Polo Vivo sticker. One can actually peel off the sticker and leave the car nameless. So in this video, we'll be looking at the top 10 annoying things about this Polo Vivo, starting with the least significant to the most significant issue. If you stick around for longer, maybe you might see more than 10 issues, who knows. Welcome to another video. The first issue is the lack of fog lamps. The entry-level Polo Vivo Trendline doesn't come with fog lamps, and driving in an area with dense fog without fog lamps is a pain in the ass. I don't know why VW didn't include fog lamps, cause even budget cars such as the Renault Kwid and Kia Picanto come with fog lamps. Issue number two is that this car doesn't have a panic handle, so you have nothing to hold on to when you are just cruising around. You end up holding the roof upholstery and it becomes dirty with time. At number 3, we have the issue of the radio. This radio doesn't have a CD player. But then again, who plays CDs in 2021? So to compensate for the lack of a CD player, they have included a USB port, a card reader, and an auxiliary input. Issue number 4 is that only the front windows are electric. At the back, you have to do the winding yourself to open the windows. That could be a big problem for some people, but for me it's not a big deal, but it's an issue nonetheless. Then we have the middle seat at the back. Trying to carry 3 adult passengers at the back is an extreme sport. The passenger in the middle will obstruct your view no matter how hard you can try to adjust the rear view mirror. All you can see is their silly face, and that makes driving difficult. The next problem is that this car doesn't show your average fuel consumption figures, and also doesn't show how far you can drive with the remaining fuel. The one big problem is that you can't adjust the height of the driver's seat. The seat only moves forward and backwards. So if you have 2 small letters in your height jeans, you will struggle to find a comfortable driving position because the height of the seat cannot be adjusted. And then there's the issue of the side mirrors. The mirrors are not electrically adjustable. You have to adjust them manually, and that could be very tricky if you try to adjust them while driving. The last problem is the power output. This car is slow sometimes, but it gets the job done. You just have to get used to it. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more car content in Mzansi Context.